today is Friday evening, 9 o'clock. Tomorrow we are going to be flying to California from from Chicago. We have an 8:50 a.m. flight in Chicago. In order to get to Chicago, it's a 3-hour drive, and our flight is at 8:50 in the morning. And I will need to supercharge on the way there a little bit. The supercharger at St. Joseph's, which is about 90 minutes away, or 90 miles away. Should be cool to take the Tesla, but still. So the problem is, I can get to the airport, and then I'm flying back on Monday. So then when I get back to the car, I need enough juice to go somewhere to charge, because I can't leave it plugged in at the airport, even though there are chargers, because they have fees and stuff. But the nearest supercharger is only 15, 16 miles away, so I don't need a whole lot of charge. If it is too low, like I said, in the parking structure, there are level 2 chargers. But anyway, I think that'll all work out itself. Yeah, we gotta get to bed soon, so we can, because we're gonna be probably getting up around 4. My first trip using the Tesla Weekender bag. I am literally just going to be gone the weekend. Even with the pair of shoes, it closes pretty good. It will be pretty cool testing out the Weekend bag on a weekend trip.
St. Joseph's in good time, actually 10 minutes early, or at least earlier than predicted. We averaged 420 watt hours per mile, which is about what I thought. Conditions were as good as they could be. It's 40 degrees, which isn't too bad, dry conditions, and I pumped the tires up to 42 psi, so to get as little rolling resistance out of my snow tires as possible. So that's pretty good. We did use more energy than trip planner estimated, but that's typical for winter and going freeway speeds. So we do have to charge 10 minutes longer than it predicted, but we got here 10 minutes faster, so kind of a wash. There's a Panera here, so I'm gonna go to the bathroom. Supercharger to here, and we managed to average 371 watt hours per mile, which is really good. Some of the freeways were slower, and I was pretty much limited to 70 miles an hour in order to get here with 15% to spare. Originally, I had predicted at the supercharger we'd get here with 26% left, but of course that's wrong. So, I got here with 15% to spare. Hopefully that's enough to heat the car over the weekend and also get me to the supercharger that's near the airport, which is 16 miles away. So I just need enough juice on the way back to get to that supercharger, and then we should be good. It smells like diesel.
Good morning. I am in mother country, reporting to you now this morning. I'm in California, and Northern California, sort of lower Bay Area. Really pretty. The drought's over here, and everything's green, at least for a few months. So, here's the situation. Today's Monday. I'm flying back to Chicago, where the Tesla is parked in a parking garage. Parked it there on Saturday morning, very early. I had 13% left. Now I have 8% left. Yeah, I don't know if you can see that. Yeah. Anyway, so 8% charge, which means I will probably not have enough to get to the supercharger, which is 17 miles away. I'm going to be getting in tonight on Eastern time, well, Central time, at 8:50 or something like that. So it's probably going to be either high 30s or low 40s. So still pretty cold, so it's going to need some warm-up time. So basically, I didn't get there with enough charge to get me to my next destination. Good news is, though, there's charge point chargers, level 2s, in the garage there. So I need to find those. If those are open, I can charge a little bit there. Otherwise, the cell phone waiting area at Midway Airport also has one charger there. So that means I'm going to be getting in really late, because I'll be level 2 charging just enough to get to the supercharger, and then I'll be supercharging until I can get to St. Joseph's, and I have to charge there to get home. Then I have to go to work the next morning. So it's going to be quite an adventure, but at least the supercharging is free, so that's really fun. Yeah. Car is still here, which is really nice. Let's see, I should probably carry the key with me. Okay, there we go. Don't see any dings on this side. Ah. Ooh. 7%. Hey, I want this focus. There we go. 7%. Good. I was doubting whether I had brought this, but I did. So we should be good. So I got to just go around the corner to the level 2. Chargers. I got here with 13%. Let's see, Saturday. Today's Monday, so I guess that's... Well, we got here early Saturday, so yeah, that is 3 days. And it's cold here. It's below freezing at night. But right now, it's almost 40 degrees, so it's not that cold. But that's a pretty good amount of energy loss overnight. So I calculated that, well, yeah, okay. Here we go. Try this station first. What did it say? Tap card to end. Okay. Alright, we're getting 30 amps, 200 volts, 6 kilowatt.
pretty slow, but I need to get to 11 hours remaining. Let's see, charge. I need to get to here. Ah. And look at that, it shows that... Oh, so even you don't even have to tap on the supercharger, it automatically has a little bar thing above it. Anyway, let's tap on that. Oh, this is saying it's only 14.5 miles. Country Club Hills. Yeah, it's saying I'll get there with minus 2%, which I believe... Yeah, let me do some quick calculations here. Let me see. Alright, so if you follow... Hold on here. Jason Hughes Hacking has revealed that the total available in a 70 kilowatt, I think, is 68. It might be a little generous, but anyway. Okay, so 68 times, I have 7%, so 0.07. That means I probably have a usable 4.7 kilowatt hours left. So that means if I had to go 15 miles, I would need to get 3 miles... per, let's just divide that by 15. Yeah, I'd have to get 317 watt hours per mile, which I probably could do with summer conditions and summer tires, but I'm going to be using at least 400 watt hours per mile. And I'm probably going to be closer to 500. So let's see, 15 miles times, let's just go 0.5. So that means I should have an available 7.5 kilowatt hours. That's how much I need. And that is 11% of the usable battery. So I need to charge to 11%. So for the time being, it's just a waiting game. It quickly went up to 8% from 7. So I guess I was on the high side of 7%, but it's now at 8%. So pretty slow. Okay. I charged up to 13%, which was an addition of about 3 kilowatt hours, maybe a little bit extra. So now, gotta figure out how to get out of the parking garage and down to Country Club Hills. Okay, here's the exit. So the total charge for this little excursion was $2.14 for the charging. But, toll booth is up there. But it's the time that's critical. Oh, and it didn't warm my battery very much, so. We'll see. I think, you know, the faster the battery charges, I guess you can't see me, hold on. There we go. The faster the battery charges, the more heat it creates.
In 0.1 miles at the T-junction, turn left onto West 55th Street.
So it would heat up the battery more. I'm sure it'll heat up just fine once I get to the supercharger. But anyway, yeah, whew, I'm already down to 12%. Okay, hopefully I make it.
Hello.
Hi, how are you? So Trip Planner is telling me that I have...
Now turn left onto
I'll have 3%
West 55th
when I get
Street.
There, so hopefully that's true. Okay, so far we're going really good. I mean, it's only been like a mile, but I'm averaging under 350 watt hours per mile, actually about 340, which is really good. Conditions are good, been able to keep driving very smooth and maximize a little bit of regen that I have. I've also got the consumption graph up here.
You'll see over on the right, it's estimates 23 miles of range, and I've got it set to 5 miles. So it's analyzing the last 5 miles of driving data and saying I've got a predicted 23 miles. This is actually pretty handy because as long as this graph predicts that you have more miles than you have left in your trip, then you're good. As soon as that starts telling you that you have fewer miles than you need to go, then that's in trouble. So it is just me. I am heading back to, or I'm going home tonight. Obviously, that's where I'm driving. But Lacey and Cordy are not gonna fly back until Sunday. She went to visit her family in Southern California for a little bit. So anyway, I am making a late night of it. I still have to go. It's 10 o'clock right now. Ooh, actually, and I'm in Chicago, so it's actually 11 o'clock? Ooh boy, I'm getting in late. Alright, I made it to the supercharger. I've got 4% left, so that means that it was good that, it's a little windy. That means that it was good that I charged there. Although I could have made it. I could have made it with, let's see, I charged up to 13%, so I could have made it if I had left at 9%, which would have saved me like 15 or 20 minutes into this super late night. Plug in the next destination here. We gotta go all the way to here. What? Oh, okay. So it was 100 miles to the airport, but it's only 70 miles from the supercharger to the next supercharger. Now, Trip Planner is saying I have, when I got here, it said 40 minutes to charge to get to the next supercharger. And that might sound like a lot, which it is, since it's only 72 miles. So that's like an hour of charging, but an hour of driving. But 40 minutes of charging, that's pretty high. But I think the reason is I arrived here with 4%, so it has to charge to 20%, which is when it says you're, which is the reserve that it keeps, and then it has to charge for the total amount to get to the next supercharger. So it's, not only does it have to put in the energy to get to the next area, it also has to recharge the reserve 20%. So I may not go all the way up to 20% above. I might leave before that because I am getting pretty good efficiency. Even on the freeway, I think I'll be under 400 because conditions are really dry and smooth. And so I might be able to put, and then if I have to, I can slow down. But I'm probably going to charge the minimal amount. I don't want to hang around too long. I just want to get home, and I don't need any energy left when I get home. I can just charge the car in the garage. So.
Now at the St. Joseph Supercharger. So we need to go, where is it? Oh, there it is. Okay, yeah, all the way to Grand Rapids here.
So we made decent time. Boy, it's almost 1:15 in the morning.
My energy efficiency though is fairly impressive for the freeway driving that we were doing. 298 watt hours per mile, which is pretty low. And yeah, I made it here with 10% to spare. Originally Trip Planner had predicted 14%, I think. I'll charge up
with enough to go, and then I'll charge up till it says I have 10% to spare, and then I think I'll leave, because that seemed to work well for this trip, so.
Well, I made it back, actually last night. At 3 a.m. I made it back. Ooh, boy, it was a long trip. Plugged in now. I'm very glad I had my level 2 adapter. I would not have made it to the supercharger if I hadn't been able to charge with the charge point chargers there. But, yeah, so that type of scenario is definitely a limitation of having a vehicle like the 70D. The smaller battery pack, because it's really difficult to have enough charge to do trips other than going between superchargers if you don't have somewhere you can plug in while it's parked. I have to look into whether or not you can, like, keep your vehicle plugged into those chargers, like, while you're parked there several days. I mean, that seems there were only two in the parking garage, and both of them were unused. They're not that commonly used, but it's kind of like, you know, that's not going to work if everybody does that. But on the other hand, it's not going to work if you don't do that. So if I was able to plug in the Chicago airport parking garage, which is 190 miles from home, then my vehicle would have been charged when I flew back and got there. And it would essentially have been like, you know, kind of driving a gas car. I would have had to stop in St. Joseph's probably, because it is winter and I don't think I can make it all the way back home in one shot, but it would have been much less. As it was, you know, disembarking on the plane took a while, and I think I lost a half hour just getting from my plane seat, maybe even 40 minutes, and then I had to catch a ride on the shuttle bus, which was kind of crowded, so that was a little difficult. And then, then there's the ride, which is about 10 minutes, and then I had to plug into the charger, and I ended up charging for 40 minutes, which was overkill. I probably could have charged for 25, 30 minutes, but I didn't know. I wasn't sure how much I was going to use. And then that was just to get me to the supercharger, which would get me to the next supercharger, which would then get me home. So it just would have been much simpler if, A, I had 85. If I had charged up to 75% on an 85, because when we went out there on the first supercharger, I charged up to 75%, and that got us to the airport. And if I had charged to 75% on an 85 battery, I would have had enough to get from the airport to the next supercharger when I got back, and then home. So that would have solved it. Or if I had somewhere to, you know, just slow charge while the car was sitting there for a few days. So it's still fun to drive the car down there, and except for the charge in the parking garage, which was only like a little over $2, supercharging was free. So. And it's just fun to have the vehicle, and I used autopilot almost the entire way. So, and especially when I was getting pretty tired on the way home, that was very advantageous. I was surprised how efficient the car was. I think it was warm enough. It was in the 30s and 40s, which is not super cold Fahrenheit. So, what is that? That would be like 0 to, I don't know, probably less than 10 degrees Celsius. On the freeway, I was at 70 miles an hour. I think I was about 300 watt hours per mile, which is really good. And then in some areas I was able to increase my speed. So I actually ended up using more than that, but, my tires were about 42 PSI and the conditions were dry. So it was ideal in terms of winter conditions. So yeah, it was a good trip, but some lessons learned. Got to do a little more research into the charge point superchargers, level 2 chargers. But yeah, the car was still reliable and fun to drive. And so yeah, if we fly out of Chicago again, which probably we will, because it's cheaper to do that,
definitely consider doing it again. Just, you know, fine-tuning a few things so we're not so short on time and not either getting back so late or leaving so early. But so that's it. That was trip two.
Oh.
Well, I guess we're out of time. My garage light went out.